grace, mercy, and peace from our Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, be with you, and also with you.
Well, good morning, everyone. Very warm welcome to you too. Have a seat for a moment or two. And a special welcome, of course, to all those who've come specially for the christening today of Maisie and Sophie. One of them sitting beautifully there with a bunch of flowers, and one of them, I think, fast asleep at the moment. So, very warm welcome to you. Many of you will know St. Mary's quite well. Many of you will have probably been at the wedding a little while ago. Some of you may be coming here for the very first time, but wherever you come from, however well you know, it's a very warm welcome to you. People have been coming to this church for, well, hundreds and hundreds of years for special moments like this. So today's special moment plays its own important part in the rich fabric of all that has happened here. And I hope that you can feel a little part of that. Feel the welcome of the regular congregation scattered around, and feel that you can relax and enjoy the service. And if you've got small children with you, please don't worry about them making a noise. That's quite all right. And you know, it's important that all of you can relax and enjoy it as well. We'll find ways of involving them as we go through the service as well. But if you've got a little one and they're getting restless, many of you already found the toy corner, the children's corner at the back. Feel that you can take them and wander around, wander outside. That's absolutely fine as well. Having said relax and enjoy the service, I do want you all to join in. We're not just here as spectators or witnesses. Everyone's got their part to play today. In welcoming Maisie and Sophie into God's family, and in pledging ourselves to them and supporting their parents and godparents. So hopefully everyone's got one of the orders of service, and that's got all the words that you need. Other words are in our big book. So some of the service is going to be led by myself, and some is going to be led by my colleague Sam. And a few other quick notices. I think Hayley and Henry have asked someone to take photos as we go through the service. So there will be some photos that I'm sure will be doing the rounds afterwards. Others of you would be grateful if you could hold fire till afterwards. If technology works, we are videoing the service as well, so that will be on our YouTube channel a bit later on today. We do take a collection for the work of the church during the service. You see there's a prominently placed collection plate during the third hymn. If you are willing to make a donation to St. Mary's, please come and put something in the collection plate, or I think scattered around on the pews are some little QR codes which take you through to a giving website. So if you've not brought anything with you, just you can scan that. Join this also communion service. Communion, sharing the bread and wine is obviously one of the key things that we do as Christians, and it seems especially important after making two new Christians today that those who would normally take communion have that opportunity to do so. So if you would take communion in your own church, wherever that is, whatever denomination, please feel you're welcome to take communion here. We go up to the high altar. One of our wonderful welcomer size people will kind of direct you up to the high altar, and we just come back through the Lady Chapel. If you don't take communion, please feel that you can come forward to the altar rail for a blessing. I think that's probably enough notices for now. Let's pray for Maisie and Sophie before we sing our first hymn. We rejoice today with the family of Maisie and Sophie as they thank God for the gift of life and bring their daughters for baptism. God, our Creator, we thank you for the wonder of new life and the mystery of human love. We give thanks for all whose support and skill surround and sustain the beginning of life. As Jesus knew love and discipline within a human family, may Maisie and Sophie grow in strength and wisdom. As Mary knew the joys and pains of motherhood, give to Henry and Hayley your sustaining grace and love through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So we're going to stand and sing our first hymn in your green hymn books, number 21, All Things Bright and Beautiful. Almighty God, by the power and discipline of Lent, may we enter into the mystery of Christ's sufferings, and by following in his way, come to share in his glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please sit for our reading.
Brothers and sisters, join in imitating me and observe those according to the example you have in us. For many live as enemies of the cross of Christ. I have often told you of them, and now I tell you even with tears. Their end is destruction, their God is the belly, and their glory is in their shame. Their minds are set on earthly things. But our citizenship is in heaven, and it is from there that we are expecting a Saviour, the Lord Jesus Christ. He will transform the body of our humiliation so that it may be conformed to the body of his glory by the power that also enables him to make all things subject to himself. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, stand firm in the Lord in this way, my beloved. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So we're going to sing our next hymn now. One More Step Along the World I Go, number 405. The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. At that very hour, some Pharisees came and said to Jesus, "Get away from here, for Herod wants to kill you." He said to them, "Go and tell that fox for me. Listen, I am casting out demons and performing cures today and tomorrow. And on the third day, I finish my work. Yet today, tomorrow, and on the next day, I must be on my way, because it is impossible for a prophet to be killed away from Jerusalem. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, the city that kills the prophets and stones those who are sent to it. How often have I desired to gather your children together as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, and you are not willing. See, your house is left to you. And I tell you, you will not see me until the time comes when you say, 'Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.'" This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I took a UK citizenship test yesterday. It was in preparation for this sermon. I failed. So if you hear of a deportation order, it's all your fault. Thankfully, it wasn't the real thing. It was one of those online exercises, and it was a strange little affair. I didn't know how many there are in the Council of Europe. Lots of vague... 47. It was multiple choice, so some were guessed rightly. Or who was the director of Chariots of Fire? Hugh Hudson, apparently. Or how many Welsh Assembly members there are? 30, 90, 120 or 60? 60. I think I guessed 90. You'll be pleased to know that I got the one about the head of the Church of England right. Anyone want to guess think who that is? Thank you, Joyce. The trick answer was the Archbishop of Canterbury. And of course, the Queen is the supreme governor, the head of the Church of England. What a strange little group of things, sort of a range of things you need to know if you want to become a UK citizen. Well, why was I taking a citizenship test? It's because I was struck by something that we heard in our first Bible reading, read by Anne, something that St. Paul wrote to the Christians in the Roman colony of Philippi in northern Greece. And he urges them to stand firm, to live in hope, to live transformed lives. And the reason they can do this, he argues, is that their true home, their true citizenship, is in heaven. Our citizenship is in heaven, he writes, and it's from there that we're expecting our Saviour. Therefore, my brothers and sisters whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, stand firm in the Lord in this way, my beloved. Well, thankfully, of course, being a citizen of somewhere is much more than answering questions and knowing stuff, isn't it? It's about counting somewhere as a home. It's to do with a covenant between the individual and the state. We agree to embody the values and norms of that place in exchange for certain privileges. And Paul says that those Philippian Christians, and by extension us today, were to live on earth as colonists, knowing that our true home is God's kingdom. That's where they belong, that's where we belong. And so the values and norms he wants them to embody are not in the end those of Rome and those of Caesar or those of the Roman army, but those of God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. And that was one of the reasons that early Christians were seen as so dangerous. And maybe today the word citizen doesn't carry the same level of meaning as it would have done to those people in Philippi or today perhaps to the people of Ukraine. And I wonder how much we do live as citizens of heaven. So if I had to ask you where your true home was, what would you say? Where has your allegiance? Is your true home Wedmore? Is it England, the UK, Europe? Kingdom of God. And today, we're going to welcome two new citizens of heaven, Maisie and Sophie. And I guess that they haven't yet been abroad in their young lives. Well, not many of us have, let's face it, in the last 2 years, have we? So, they haven't yet needed one of these. I've got one of the new black ones. I think it's black or is it blue? I can never quite... tell whether it's very, very, very dark blue or black. Have you ever read the front piece in your passport? A little bit on the inside cover. This is what it says. Her Britannic Majesty's Secretary of State requests and requires in the name of Her Majesty All those whom it may concern to allow the bearer to pass freely without let or hindrance, and to afford the bearer such assistance and protection as may be necessary. Impressive words. Do you have confidence in them? Have you ever tested them out? Have you ever brandished them in front of some petty official and asked for cooperation? I'm pretty sure I know what the answer would be. Incarceration, a long stay, strip search. They have the ring of empty words. But Paul was able to urge those Christians to have confidence in the citizenship of the kingdom of heaven, because he knew that the values of God's kingdom will prevail and are worth living out and fighting for, because Christ is raised from the dead and will come again. We can put our trust in our true home, because God, he's already shown us that his kingdom is stronger than the death, the arbitrary justice, the armed forces, the bombs that are the weapons of the powers of this world. Maisie and Sophie may not yet have a UK passport, but they will soon have one of these. Their baptism certificate, with a picture of the font on the front, to show their true citizenship. They're joining God's family today, God's household, and with their christening, they're going to take on full citizens' rights. And of course, they've got visas already stamped on their passport. The water that's going to be poured on their heads as a sign that God forgives. God's always offering a new start, washing away the old. They've got the sign of the cross marked on their foreheads with blessed olive oil. A sign that Jesus pledges himself to us, calls us by name. And then they're going to get a candle at the end as well. A candle that's a sign that God has a role for them as citizens in his kingdom, to take his light into the world, to roll back the darkness. So Maisie and Sophie, welcome today to God's family. May you always have confidence in your citizenship of God's kingdom. Confidence in Jesus. May you live out his values, his love, and his light all the days of your lives. Amen.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the part in our service where we are going to ask Henry and Hayley to bring Sophie and Maisie up to the front here for the baptism, and also at the same time to invite the godparents to come up as well. And we're going to, first of all, Richard will lead us in the next part, which is where everyone introduces themselves. Yeah.
So at the bottom of page two of our orders of service, where it says the presentation of the candidates. So here they come. One is being disturbed as we speak. A very special moment, this, isn't it? I think, Henry, you were christened in that font, weren't you? Tom as well?
Yeah.
Tom, and so there'll be a number of people in this church day christened in that very font, and so many generations of Wedmore children also. So, well, welcome Hayley, welcome Henry, welcome Maisie, and Sophie. Look, they've got lovely matching dresses and cardies on as well. And we're going to ask the godparents to introduce themselves now, aren't we?
So
before we get down to the details of our baptism, it'd be nice to perhaps to hear a little bit from our esteemed Gopo, just your name and who you are and how you know Henry and Haley, just so everybody else knows who you are.
I'm Tom, and I'm friends with Henry and Haley. There's an usher at their wedding.
I'm Maddie, and Top Henry's my godfather.
I'm Sam, and Henry's my brother.
I'm Natalie, and I'm Haley's sister.
I'm Rosie, and I'm Haley's sister.
And I'm Joss, a friend of Henry and Haley.
Some people don't need quite an introduction, as others say. It's wonderful to have you.
Well, thank you all, because it's important to introduce them, because everyone will hopefully know Henry and Haley, but not everyone will know the godparents, and they're going to play a really important part in Maisie or Sophie, well, hopefully both of them, but certainly their own godchild lives in their early lives, so it's good to hear from them as well.
And of course, it's not just the parents and godparents that take a part in all this, but of course, it's everyone else who is gathered here today. And so, there's a part, if you look in your order, that I'm going to ask you to respond. Faith is the gift of God to his people. In baptism, the Lord is adding to our number those who he is calling. People of God, will you welcome these two children, uphold them in their new life in Christ.
With the help of God, we will.
And so parents and godparents, the church receives Maisie and Sophie with joy. Today we are trusting God for their growth in faith. Will you pray for them? Draw them by your example into the community of faith and walk with them in the way of Christ. And I realise you've not got your orders of service, have you? So, let's go grab a few, and we'll do that bit again. So, probably, I think it's top of page 3 we'll want. There we are. So, let's do that bit again, so they know what they... So, they don't have to remember everything. Parents and godparents, the church receives Sophie and Maisie with joy. Today we are trusting God for their growth in faith. Will you pray for them, draw them by your example into the community of faith, and walk with them in the way of Christ?
In baptism, these two children begin their journey in faith. You speak for them today. Will you care for them and help them to take their place within the life and worship of Christ Church?
With the help of God, we will.
So they're going to make their pledges now. In baptism, God calls us out of darkness into his marvelous light. To follow Christ means dying to sin and rising to new life with him. Parents and godparents, I ask, do you reject the devil and all rebellion against God? Do you renounce the deceit and corruption of evil?
I renounce them.
Do you repent of the sins that separate us from God and neighbour?
I repent.
Do you turn to Christ as Saviour?
I turn to Christ.
Do you submit to Christ as Lord?
I submit to Christ.
Do you come to Christ, the way, the truth, and the life?
Going to, as I mentioned, put the sign of the cross on Maisie and Sophie's forehead now, using some oil blessed specially for the purpose. Sophie and Maisie, Christ claims you for his own. Receive the sign of the cross. Do Do not be ashamed to confess the faith of Christ crucified. And together we say, fight valiantly as a disciple of Christ against sin, the world, and the devil, and remain faithful to Christ to the end of your life. May Almighty God deliver you from the powers of darkness, restore in you the image of his glory, and lead you in the light and obedience of Christ. Amen.
And we now want to ask the godparents, if you would come forward and just take a little bit of the oil on your fingers and mark
your respective godchild, I guess. Just with the sign of the cross again. Sign of your commitment to them.
So now, having done that signing, we are going to process to the font over here. And we'd like to encourage as many of you as possible to sort of gather around the font. So if you parents and godparents...
Everyone out of their seats, if you can find a space nearby. Children, come up near the front so they can see what's happening as well. Come on. Regular congregation as well, very much invited.
There we go, the light goes on. So we now take our baptism, which is as much part of Wedmore's history and heritage as it's donated to by a family of a young man who died on the Western Front during the Great War. And again, it binds everyone into that history and heritage, which Maisie and Sophie will soon be joining. So we pour this into our font. See, going into there. It's
suitably warmed.
Beautifully warm. And we say the prayer over the waters, which you can find in your order of service. Praise God, who made heaven and earth,
who keeps his promise forever.
Thanks to the Lord our God. Is it right to give thanks
and praise?
Almighty God, whose Son, Jesus Christ, was baptized in the River Jordan, we thank you for the gift of water to cleanse and revive us. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism.
In it we are buried with Christ in his death. By it we share in
his resurrection. Through it we are
reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son,
we baptize into his fellowship Maisie and Sophie. In faith.
Send your Holy Spirit
upon them and bring them to new birth in the household of faith, and raise them with Christ to full and eternal life. For all might, majesty, and authority and powers are yours, now and forever. Amen.
And brothers and sisters, I ask you all now to profess together with the parents and the godparents the faith of the Church. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, who made all things?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ, who redeemed the world?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in his Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God?
We believe and trust.
This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. So
now, here we go.
Who's first? I think Maisie's first. It's Henry. Lean her over. And can you name her, please?
Maisie Elizabeth G.
I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now we have Sophie. Just hold it.
Hold it, please, if you stand up.
Right. I want to, that's fine.
And can you name her, please?
Sophie Lily Ruth.
I baptize you, Sophie Lily Ruth, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Well done. That was all right, wasn't it?
May God, who has received you by baptism into his church, pour upon you the riches of his grace, that within the company of Christ's pilgrim people, you may daily be renewed by the anointing of the Spirit and come to the inheritance of his saints in glory. Amen.
Amen. Well, we brought Maisie and Sophie to baptism knowing that Jesus died and rose again for them, and trusting in the promise that God hears and answers prayer. We pray that in Jesus Christ, they will know the forgiveness of their sins and the new life of the Spirit. As they grow up, they will need the help and the encouragement of the Christian community so that they may learn to know God in public worship and private prayer, follow Jesus Christ in the life of faith, serve their neighbour after the example of Christ, and in due course come to confirmation. As part of the Church of Christ, we all have a duty to support them by prayer, example, and teaching. As their parents and godparents, you have prime responsibility for guiding and helping them in their early years. This is a demanding task for which you will need the help and the grace of God. Therefore, let us now pray for grace in guiding these children in the way of faith. Faithful and loving God, bless those who care for these children. Henry, Haley, Natalie, Rosie, Maddie, Joss, Tom, Sam, and their grandparents. Grant them your gifts of love, wisdom, and faith. Pour upon them healing and reconciling love, and protect their home from all evil. Fill them with the light of your presence and establish them in the joy of your kingdom through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And if you'd all like to return to your seats, and David is going to lead us in some further prayers.
Lord our God, source of all goodness and love, in the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon all who turn to you for help. We pray for the people of Ukraine and for the people of Russia. We pray that the humanitarian corridors will remain open. We pray for the refugees. We pray for the sick and the wounded and for the families of those killed. We pray that the fighting might cease. Lord, in thy mercy. Amen. Loving God, deliver us from a world without justice and a future without mercy. In your mercy, establish justice. And in your justice, remember the mercy revealed to us in Jesus Christ our Lord. We pray for those caught in a spiral of deprivation, crime and violence, and that they may see that there are other paths. Help and guide all who work in the criminal justice sector, the police, those who work in the court system, the probation service, and the prisons. Lord, in thy mercy. God of compassion, your love for humanity was revealed in Jesus, whose earthly life began in the poverty of a stable and ended in the pain and the isolation of the cross. We hold before you those who are homeless, cold, and hungry. Draw near and comfort them in spirit, and bless those who work to provide them with shelter, food, and friendship. We pray for the work of the charities for the homeless and for the refugees, for volunteers who give their time for others, for people who give up their homes for others. Lord, in thy mercy. We pray for our church family. We pray for Jill Morse in advance of her going into hospital. And we pray for all those we know who are sick. We pray for the parents and godparents and for Maisie and for Sophie. God, who would hold both heaven and earth in a single piece, let the design of thy great love lighten upon the waste of our wrath and sorrows. And together we say, merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Well, we've all got an opportunity to say some words of welcome now to Maisie and Sophie. So I'm going to ask Henry and Hayley just to come and join us on the stack again. If you want to turn to your orders of service, we are on page 5, about two-thirds of the way down page 5 for the welcome. I'm going to ask you all to stand. So we do this, and we're going to walk around the church so everyone gets a good sight of these two fantastic little girls. So let's wander around, and we'll say the words. There is one Lord, one faith, one baptism. Sophie and Daisy, by one Spirit, we are all baptized into one body. We welcome you into the fellowship of the faith. We are children of the same Heavenly Father. We welcome you. Let's give them a big round of applause. And if you'd like to be seated again, the choir have their own words of welcome that they would like to sing for Maisie and Sophie.
Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. He has given us access to his grace. My brothers and sisters in Christ, the peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. Please stand and turn and wave at someone in your pew. Share with them the sign of peace.
Offertory hymn now, during which we'll take our collection for the work of the church, is number 422. Praise my soul, the King of Heaven.
With this bread we bring, we shall remember Jesus. With this wine that we bring, we shall remember Jesus. Bread for his body, wine for his blood. Gifts from God to this table we bring, we shall remember Jesus. The Lord is here.
His Spirit
is with us. Lift up your hearts.
Lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is right to praise you, Father, Lord of all creation. In your love you made us for yourself. When we turned away, you did not reject us, but came to meet us in your Son. You embraced us as your children and welcomed us to sit and eat with you. In Christ, you shared our life that we might live in him and he in us. he opened his arms of love upon the cross and made sacrifice for sin. On the night that he was betrayed, he took supper with his friends. He took bread, gave thanks, broke it, gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." We do this in remembrance of him. His body is the bread of life. At the end of supper, he took the cup of wine. He gave thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His blood is shed for all. As we proclaim his death and celebrate his rising in glory, send your Holy Spirit that this bread and this wine may be to us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy gifts, make us one in Christ our risen Lord. With your whole church throughout the world, we offer you this sacrifice of praise and lift our voice to join the eternal song of heaven. Holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. And our Saviour hath come, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
yours.
Almighty God, thank you for feeding us
with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit and work to your praise and glory.
Very much. welcome to that. Hopefully you were given either a sort of postcard as you came in or a little bookmark. Those are for everyone's takeaway. So a reminder of today, a reminder to pray for Maisie and Sophie, for Henry and Haley and godparents. Please do take that away with you. Sam's got some bands of marriage to read.
I published the Bands of Marriage between Aaron Guy Yates Rossiter and Roxanne Marie Higgins. And this is for the first time of asking. If anyone knows any reason in law why these persons may not marry each other, you are to declare it now. Let's pray for Aaron and for Roxanne as they prepare for their wedding. Lord, the source of true love, we pray for Aaron and for Roxanne. Grant them joy of heart, seriousness of mind, reverence of spirit, that as they enter the oneness of marriage, they may be strengthened and guided by you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
So we've got our final hymn now, which is Shine Jesus Shine, number 317.
Thank you.
come to the end of our baptism service, we come to now the lighting of our candle. And in this baptism service, the candle, the light of the candle, symbolizes to us the light that we receive from Christ. And it's not a light to be kept in church, but it's a light to be taken out into the world, because there is not enough darkness in the world that cannot extinguish the light of one candle. And so we once again invite Hayley and Henry and the girls to come forward and receive their baptism candles. And if anybody else here has received, brought their baptism candles with them, they're also invited at this stage to come forward as we get to come towards the end of our service. So we're at the very end of our orders of service on the back page. God has delivered us from the dominion of darkness and has given us a place with the saints in light. Sophie and Maisie, you've received the light of Christ. Walk in this light all the days of your life. Shine as a light in the world to the glory of God the Father. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord in the name of Christ. Amen.